Share with us. Praise David Ross, and we're going to have a good time in the Lord.
Amen.
We're going to ask the choir to give us two selections, and then we're going to come and present our speaker for tonight. Let's listen to our choir.
Oh,
for allowing us to come into your homes by way of Facebook and another means of getting the message out. It's just good to be here on tonight. And we trust that you realize that God is good and he is worthy of all of our praise. Certainly we want the Quinn family to know that we're praying for them. During that hour of bereavement, along with Sister Teresa Terrell and the family of Sister Joy Joy. And don't forget, on Friday, the funeral will be here for Sister Joy Joy. Wake is at 9 o'clock, followed by the funeral services. And then on Saturday, Sister Sutton Brown, wake is at 10 o'clock, followed by the funeral services. And we invite all of you to pray for the family during the hour of your reading. Could be us. And so God is still in the blessed business. Good to have my friend with us tonight, Pastor Ross, the pastor of the new Prospect Baptist Church here in the last capital of the world. So we thank him for making sacrifice to come and share with us. Father, this election, the next voice you hear would be that of our friend, our brother, Reverend Ross, the pastor of the new Prospect Baptist Church. Heaven is my goal. Every day, gotta keep on moving. Don't let it get the right way. Lord, if I stumble, step aside. Yeah.
Place to proclaim the word of God. One more time.
One more.
Again, thank you to all of these wonderful deacons, officers, members, and friends.
Yes, sir.
And to these pastors, Pastor Green and Pastor Morgan, and all of you, our Father's children.
Yes.
It is good for us to be in the house of prayer.
Yes.
One more time. Amen.
Yes.
All of the things that are going on in our world, it is a blessing that we have this chance and opportunity to come to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth. Amen. It is a blessing to come to the Lord's house and to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Those of you that have your word today, we promise we won't hold you too long. If you go with us, a very familiar passage of scripture found in Psalms 124. Psalms 124. Come say, trouble in my way. I have to cry sometime.
Against us.
The waters overwhelmed us. The stream had gone over our soul. That the proud waters had gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who had not given us as prey to their teeth. Our soul is escaped as the bird out of the snare of the flower. The snare is broken. We are escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who has made the heavens and the earth. First one, when we get off from preaching, simply says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side. God bless you. May you see it. Presence of God in this holy sanctuary. While we have the time, there's a lot to share between you and I. Preach and teach on this famous subject. If it had not been, if you don't mind, can you look at someone that's in close proximity and say, neighbor, our neighbor, the preachers don't preach about it. If it had not been. At this time, brothers and sisters, we know the children of Israel are making the journey from exile back to Jerusalem. They're making their way up the mountain towards their destination. They begin to declare this song of ascent. The song is classified as a song of ascent because they are ascending up the hill of Jerusalem. They're in the home stretch of their journey, which by far is the most difficult part of their journey. But they are determined not to give up. Determined because they know they have come too far from where they started from. And no matter what the obstacle is, no matter what the obstruction is, no matter what the opposition may look like, they're determined, they're going all of the way. So the Bible says that they have this song in their spirit to help them, basically enable them to keep going the rest of the way. Amen. And then this song teaches us that sometimes, family, most time, all we have to do is praise our way through. Sometimes we may not have the resources. We may not have all the answers. We may not know what God is doing in this season. And so in order for us to get through what we're going through, we have to praise our way through. My grandma said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank God for saving me. So we may not have the answer, but we may not know what God is doing in this season, but we do know that we serve a great God. We serve a God who simply sits high and looks low on his children. And even though we may be in a storm right now, we may be in a difficult season right now, but we determine in our mind to keep going the rest of the way. Because we know, amen, as James Cleveland said, no one told us the road would be easy. No one told us that. But I just don't believe that he brought us this far just to leave us behind. And somebody can testify and say, yes, sir, preacher, I've been through some storms in my life. I've been through some difficult moments in my life. I had more money than I had money, but yet I realized in my own mind that I just don't believe he brought me this far just to leave me behind. I've been there too much. I've seen him work before. I've seen him open up some things that have been closed in my face. I've seen him open up some doors that have been closed. The rulers of family pour out blessings on my life. I see him heal some people that never were supposed to be healed before. I see him do some wonderful things. If you only believe, he will supply all of our needs according to his riches and his glory. Anybody testify and say, yes, sir, preacher, I've seen God supply all of my needs. I'm not talking about some, I'm not talking about a portion, I'm not talking about 30, a 40, a 50, a 70. But I'm talking about all of my needs. I'm simply determined to go home anyhow. Then the song teaches us that they said this song, they simply was reminiscing and saying, if it had not been for the Lord that was on our side. Then they said in verse 2, let Israel say it again, if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side. And sometimes, brothers and sisters, you got to think about it when you're going through some storms in your life and say to yourself, if it had not been for the Lord that was on our side. Some of us, amen, would not be here. Some of us would be lost. Some of us, amen, would be a ransom done. Our soul would be lost. We think about his goodness and his mercy and think about the Lord being on our side. What will we be? He's our protector. He's our shield. He's our company keeper. He's our balance. He's our protector. He's our King's Redeemer. If it had not been for the Lord that was on our side. So they continue to sing this song. Some of us, amen, have to have a song in our hearts that when the going gets tough and things get hard on us, we have to have a song in our spirit. Some of us know the song, Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I once was blind, but now I'm seeing. Some of us song may be, it may be, passing out the gentle Savior. Right? Others are not calling here. My uncle prayer. I don't know what your song is. Maybe your song is blessed. Assuring Jesus in my home. What a foretaste of glory. The kind of heir of salvation. Born of the Spirit. Washed in blood. This is my song. Praise it. My Savior. Oh, the day long. Blessed assurance. I have Jesus in me. I'm not talking about a pseudo thing. I'm talking about every day when he walks with me and he talks with me and he tells me that I am his own. And the joy after me. Tell it that none of us shall ever know. Because it's a difference, brothers and sisters, in knowing him.
Yes, sir.
Through a Sunday morning feel-good religion. Then there's a difference in knowing through the rough time that I have a comforter that in my rough season of my life that I can look to the heels who come out of my head. It's a difference between amen having a Sunday morning relationship with him than having a pseudo, a personal relationship with him. That you know, amen, that through seasons of your life and you know through dark storms of your life that God is always there. You may not be able to trace him, but you can feel him. When you can't trust him, you can trace him. You can feel his presence. You can feel him moving on the altar of your heart. Can anybody testify that when I can't see him, I can trace him in my heart.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Let's look back. Sometimes, brothers and sisters, in order for us to move forward, we have to look back sometimes. So they look back over their life, and they saw how God delivered them out of, amen, the Jordan, how God delivered them from Sidon and Og, and how God delivered them from the Red Sea, and how God delivered them through, amen, this and that. And they had to look back in the rearview mirror of their life and say, if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, now let Israel say amen. And you have to take out Israel sometimes. It had not been for the Lord who was on Charles' side, who was on Mary's side, who was on Johnny's side, who was on Michael's side, who was on Eastern Star's side, who was on New Prospect side. Where would I be? It's more of us. To move forward, sometimes we gotta look back. Look back at the rearview mirrors of our life and say, if he brought you from this thing, if he brought you from that thing, if he brought you from this sickness over here, if he brought us through Ebola over here, if he brought us through the swine flu over here, if he brought us through influenza over here, if he brought us through mad cow disease over here, surely he labored to bring us through them all. Can anybody testify? There he is. No trouble in my God. If he did it before, he can do it again. This, and that. I put it all in his hand. Why? Because he's the master of them all. Can anybody testify? Yes, sir, preacher. I put it all in his hand. Whatever it is, I put it all in his hand. This, and that. I put it all in his hands. Did he have to tell us yet? He keeps working on our behalf. He keeps blessing us when we don't deserve it. He keeps opening the windows of heaven and pouring out blessings on our life. Can anybody testify and say, yes, sir, preacher, you're looking at a miracle. You're looking at somebody that shouldn't be here today. They counted me out. They disqualified me because of my past. But because of the blood. wash away all of my sin, wash away all of my lying, wash away all of my backbiting, all of my cheating, all of my bad ways, and gave us new grace and new mercy.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, these things I've spoken to you, that you may have peace. And in this world, you will have tribulations. Be of good cheer, because I've overcome the world. Lift up your eyes, and the hill will come to all your help. Jesus said, my help comes from the Lord, which made the heavens and the earth. He will not suffer his foot to be moved. He that will keep it will not slumber, nor will sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy savior. Thy right hand, the sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy sword. The Lord shall preserve thy going in and thy coming out from this time forth, and now and forevermore.
Yes.
They were reflectors.
Oh, yes, God.
They began to look back over their life, see how he's brought them over. It reflected, but it repeated the phrase over and over again. If it had not been for the Lord that was on our side.
No.
It reminded themselves, the children and their children, and their children, to be thankful unto God who brought us through.
Yes.
Also, when we was growing up, our grandmother didn't hide their religion. But they instilled it in us.
Amen.
They told us, amen, of the God who they serve. And they told us of the God who their grandmother served. But I've come to the realization in my mind that yes, I'm thankful that my grandma knew him. I'm thankful that my mama knew him. But there's nothing better than knowing and praising him. Can anybody testify? Your grandmama may know him, your daddy may know him. But there is nothing sweeter than knowing Jesus for yourself. And I know we sing that song, save me a seat when you get there before I do. But in honesty, can't nobody save you no seat. Can't nobody mark the seat for you. You got to work out your own. Just He has forgiven us all of our sins.
Yes,
so the good news is, brothers and sisters, that we can testify to the storm and through the rain. For we know that all of us have some storms in our lives. All of us have had some rainy days in our lives. All of us have some heartache, and God knows you showed us that pain. But through it all, I said through it all, through all of my sickness, through all of my hurt, through all of the pain that I have experienced, I've learned how to trust in the Lord, because I've discovered that He has not failed us yet. And so all the days of my appointed life, I will trust in Him. And can anybody testify and say, yes, sir, preacher? I learned how to trust in Him. Because through all of the sickness, you are praised, the Lord. Like your body is already healed. You are praised, Him. Like the burdens have already been. The battle is not yours. It is the Lord. And I testify this afternoon and tell y'all a little story. Just the other day, I was reading my daughter a bedtime story entitled Humpty Dumpty. You know Humpty Dumpty? The story says Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't put Humpty Dumpty back together again. And so I took the book, put it back on the shelf. And my daughter looked at me and said, Daddy, that may be the end of the story. There gotta be more to it. I said, no, baby, that's all of the story. And looked at the book and said, ooh, daddy, I know somebody who may look to put Humpty Dumpty back together again. Ooh. I said, baby, what you talking about? She said, ooh, daddy, I know somebody who may look to put Humpty back together again. I said, baby, do tell. She said, in a whole night, the same. That walked on the water, the same God that made the whole wide world, the same God that kept us from harm, who made the king in our sin, the same God that fought all of our battles. Do you know him? Like a child of the Father, and if you try again, you lift up holy hands and say, yes, sir, preacher, I know that. The same God that kept us through the burning, the same God that kept us through cancer, the same God that kept us through AIDS, the same God that kept us through the black eyes. And you will not leave us in mouth. I don't care what they say, come from day to day, we serve a great God. Anybody know him? You can only be in time.
committed their life to the Lord.